Students, this is a data biology physics faculty. Here I would like to give a lecture on lasers. In this video I explain about the construction and working of helium neon laser. Helium neon laser is a gas laser. It was designed by Ali Javan. Now let us see what are the characteristics of helium neon laser. Now, helium neon laser is a gas laser, and the active medium in helium neon laser is mixture of helium neon gas in the ratio of 10:1. Third one is laser action is due to neon atoms. So in case of helium neon laser, the laser action which is mainly due to neon atoms. And in case of helium neon laser or in case of helium neon gas mixer, we are getting sharp energy levels. That's why we prefer electrical discharge pumping methods. For optical resonator arrangement, here we use two plane mirrors placed outside the discharge tube, which are facing face to face, and in which one is having 100% reflectivity and other one is having 99% reflectivity. This setup, it should be act as a optical resonator. The nature of output of emitted beam is continuous beam, and the emitted laser beam wavelength is 6328 angstroms, which is in red color. This is the design of helium neon laser. Now, this is discharge tube, right? This is discharge tube. This discharge tube filled with helium neon gas mixer in the ratio of 5:1 at a pressure 1 mm of Hg. The diameter of the discharge tube is around 5 mm and the length of the discharge tube around 50 centimeters. These are two plane mirrors which are placing outside the discharge tube, in which one is having 99% reflectivity and other one is having 100% reflectivity, and these two mirrors which are facing face to face. This is the arrangement of optical resonator in helium neon laser. Now in this discharge tube, these two electrodes, we are connected to electrical discharge pumping method. Now when the current is passed through this discharge tube, the fast moving electrons, these are the electrons, that is the current passes through the discharge tube, and the fast moving electrons are collided with the helium atoms in the discharge tube. The helium atoms in the discharge tube. Now these helium atoms takes the corresponding energy of electron and are excited to higher energy level. It means these helium atoms are moving with high speed in the discharge tube. Now these helium atoms, that is high speed helium atoms, collide with the neon atoms in the same discharge tube, and due to this collision it transfers its energy to the neon atoms. Neon atom takes the corresponding energy and excited to higher energy level of the same height of energy state of helium. So how much energy which is transferred, it takes the corresponding energy and excited to the same higher energy level of the neon atom. So in this process, indirectly helium atom behaves as a pumping element. It sends the neon atoms from ground level to higher level. Now these excited neon atoms, they are participating in the laser action. After laser action, these neon atoms collide with walls of the discharge tube and come down to the ground level. Now these neon atoms are again collision with helium atoms and excited to the higher level. So it is a continuous process. That's why the output beam is always continuous beam. Right? This is the general basic working style of helium neon laser. So helium neon laser tube is a 5 mm in diameter and 50 centimeters long. It contains helium neon mixer in 10:1 ratio at pressure of about 1 mm of Hg. The tube has two plane mirrors, one of them with 100% reflectivity and other with 99% reflectivity. In helium neon laser, the pumping method is electrical discharge pumping method. Now, this is working. How the laser action which is occurs in case of helium neon laser. This is the energy level diagram, right? In which this is the energy level diagram of helium and this is the energy level diagram of neon. So actually this helium and neon, which is consists of number of energy levels, but we take in which levels the laser action is occurs, that should be your focus, right? That is your making to focus. When we are observing these two energy levels which are at same height, it means here the energy is this one, here the energy is this one. So these two levels are having the same height. It means the particle which is excited from this level to this level, or the particle excited from this level to this level, the required energy should be same. So then what is the case? So collision of helium atoms with neon atoms, whenever the fast moving electron, this is the when the discharge, electrical discharge is starts, the fast moving electron is collision with the helium atom. Helium atom takes the corresponding energy and excited to higher energy state. Now here the helium atom which is moving with high speed and it is collided with the neon atom in the same discharge tube and it transfers its energy to the neon atom. Neon atom takes the corresponding energy and excited to the same higher energy state. In this level, this particle, this neon atoms which relax 10^-3 seconds. 10^-3 seconds. It is 1 lakh times more than its original relaxation time. That's why this state is act as a metastable state, and in this level the population inversion is occurs. Due to spontaneous emission, a photon comes from 5s level to 3p level by emission of photon of energy h nu, which is initiate the next stimulated emissions. So the laser action which is occurs in between the energy levels 5s and 3p and the emitted laser beam having wavelength 6328 angstroms or 632.8 nanometers. After that, due to collision with the walls of the discharge tube, the particle which is comes to ground state. Now these neon atoms again collision with the helium atoms and excited to the higher energy state. So this process is continuous process. And helium neon laser, the laser action is mainly due to neon atoms. Helium atoms are behaves as a pumping element, and helium neon laser is 4-level laser. Now, the helium neon mixer contained in the glass discharge tube is ionized by passing a DC current through the gas. As the fast moving electrons are collision with the helium atoms, these are excited to 2s level as shown in figure. In the excited 2s state, helium atoms having much more energy. The energy of this level is almost the same as the energy of 5s of neon atoms. Due to collision between helium and neon atoms, the neon atoms are excited to 5s level. In this level, the neon atom relaxes 10 to 4 minus 3 seconds. It is 1 lakh times more than its original relaxation time. So in this level, population inversion is achieved. The spontaneous transition from 3s to 3p state produces a photon of wavelength 6328 angstroms. This photon initiates the next stimulated emissions. The photons are amplified by optical resonator up to required intensity. The laser beam emerges through the end with lower reflectivity. The emitted beam is continuous beam. Helium neon laser is a 4-level laser. Now, what are the applications of helium neon laser? Helium neon laser, which are having a number of applications, but you are here, you are mentioning three applications. So, which are used in open air communication system, which are used in for the construction of holograms, and it is used to determine the size of small particles. Suppose the particles are in nano size or micro size, suppose you want to calculate its size, then we prefer helium neon laser technology to determine the size of the particles. Thank you very much, students, for supporting this. And this is one of the important essay question. The question, it may be asked as, can I explain the construction and working of helium neon laser? So this is an important topic. Thank you very much.